Hello friends, I am Hardik Patel. Welcome back to our tech channel. From this video, I am going to start a new series for design patterns using programming language Python. In this video, I am going to give you brief introduction of design patterns. And then from the next video onwards, we will learn all the design patterns one by one. So let's get started. So first question is, what is design patterns? So software design pattern is a general reusable solution to a commonly occurring problem. So let me explain this with the current scenario. So I will give my example itself. So if I am doing some programming for any project and I found some issue and I try to solve that issue, right? So I come up with the solution and that is complete, or you can say correct for me, but I don't know yet that is efficient or reliable or not, but for the time being I will use that. Again, in the future or maybe in the next project, I will face the similar issue, but that is little bit tweak we need to the same solution which I came up with, and I just tweak that and I will use that as well. So it happens multiple times, it occurs multiple times, right? And then what you will do, you will found the common pattern from all those problems, and then you will come up with the reusable and general solution for those all the problems, because all those problems are similar, just the different way, right? So same way, in the past expert did the same thing. They found the common pattern of the problems and they found the solution which is reliable, efficient and complete solution, and that is also scalable. So that was the main solution which is called as design patterns. So that were four experts published the first book with the around 21 design patterns, and those called as a gang of four because there are four members of them publishers. Okay, so I will not go into the deep that. If you want to know all the information, then you can go to the Wikipedia for that. Okay, next. So in this whole series, we will use these four parameters to understand that pattern. So what is the pattern name? What is the purpose of that pattern? How we will implement that pattern? And what is the example? So how we will use that pattern? Okay, so these all four parameters we will understand to understand that pattern. So there are three types of design patterns which were published initially, that is creational, structural and behavioral. There are another design patterns are there, but those are like found just in the near past. Okay, so still they are not standard design patterns, but still they are design patterns. So we will understand that as well. Like for example, concurrency design patterns. Okay, so those also we will understand after these three design patterns. So creational design patterns, which is used to how objects are created. So those are the examples of these design patterns. So I have just put four design patterns here in the creational design pattern section. So maybe if I am missing here any creational design pattern, you can anyway comment this out and just point me that. So I will add this here and I will also create the video for that as well. So no pattern must be left. Okay, so I am just putting here so you can understand what is missing. So these four are I have just discovered from the web, and I will explain all these four one by one. Okay, so singleton, factory, builder and prototype. Same way, structural design patterns. So what it does, this pattern simplify the structure by identifying relationships between objects. So it is useful to change the structure and just simplify that by identifying the real objects which are used the relationship. Okay, so adapter, decorator, facade and proxy, I don't know actually what is the pronunciation, exact pronunciation of facade, because I am just saying facade. Okay, so I will correct that after this video. Okay, behavioral design pattern. So using these patterns, you will be able to change the behavior of objects, how they communicate between the objects. So you can change that, you can modify that. Okay, so these are the design patterns which I have just discovered, those are chain of responsibility, strategy, observer, state, template, flywheel. Maybe there were some missing, so you can anyway point out here, so in the comment section. So I will add here, and also I will come up with the video for that as well. Okay, there is fourth one I have added here, that is concurrency design pattern. So there are so many design patterns for this concurrency design patterns, so I have just put down two names right now, and I will add if I discover and if I feel that this design patterns also must be explained, then I will add here root dreadlock pattern and thread pull pattern. Okay, so I am not going deep here, I am just showing you what we are going to cover in this whole series. Then what are the characteristics of the design patterns? So you can say it is language independent, so you can implement these design patterns in any programming language. In this web series we are going to use Python. Second point is open to improve. Still you can improve all the design patterns. Let's say for example there is a singleton design pattern, so you can write your own design pattern implementation and you can just publish that if it is improved one, so anyone can use that. Third point, those are dynamic, scalable, generic and complete solutions. As experts found this from their experience. Okay, so those are the characteristics of the design patterns. So what are the benefits of them? So anyway, you can use multiple times, so that's called reusability. Once you write this singleton class, then you can use that class as a base class in any class to make that singleton class, right? Second one is trustworthy. You can use without any worry, as those are tested multiple times by experts in their experience. Third is dependable and reliable to use. So you can depend on this and you can rely on this, as again the same thing, they were discovered by the experts, they were used also, so you can use that as well. So those are the benefits I have discovered. So that is the brief introduction, and I will start this new series from the next video. I will start with the first design pattern and then one by one I will create that. So that's it from this video. If you have any comments, if you feel that something is missing in this video, then also you can comment out, and see you soon in the next video with the first design pattern, that is singleton design pattern. Until then, enjoy single patterns designing programming. Okay, thanks for watching.